So what have you heard from people in your travels around the country?
Stop the spending. Stop the spending. Don't raise taxes. The deficit is absolutely out of control. Spending's out of control, and that we can't keep borrowing lest we have a bank. We are a bankrupt nation. But entitlements need to be addressed. I mean, there are some real long-term issues that need to be addressed that going forward determine whether or not we're a viable country moving forward.
But do you think that we can be a viable country moving forward without making sure that people are, their health is taken care of, for example?
Well, take health care, for example. I mean, I heard health care reform. You know, that's what I heard. I didn't hear about insurance entitlement, which is, I think, what we ended up, insurance entitlement or in the insurance industry entitlement, all right? But what I heard was let's reduce costs, which I think really is the issue when it comes to health care. Well, to do that, in my opinion, you've really got to be free market based. We need to open up healthcare to the free market. We need to blow the lid off of supply. I had this vision that maybe we'd see Gallbladders R Us on the corner offering gallbladder surgery for thousands of dollars rather than tens of thousands of dollars. We didn't do anything with regard to supply. What we ended up with, and I realize that this is not a bill that has passed Congress yet, what we ended up with is a bill that would put would 30 million more Americans would drop on an industry that has no more supply. So to me, you'd be rationing services and that costs would go up. We need to blow the lid off of supply and really see what the free market could do for healthcare. And the government could do that. The government could really drop barriers to entry into healthcare. Something that would happen if we just do it. But those are the solutions we should have seen, and none of those came about. None of them. None.
And so you think it's government's role to come in and provide the framework for private companies to actually do the work?
Government to come in and provide the framework that economy can thrive as a result of it being a level playing field, of not granting corporate welfare, if you will, not granting certain corporations advantages that others don't, which is happening every single day, which exists in our system, which exists in the state of New Mexico also. The government has a role to provide this level playing field, which I'm going to argue we've lost sight of with the bailouts, that we've lost complete sight of with this trillion-dollar incentive package.
Is it also the government's role to hold companies accountable?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So you create this level playing field, and it's government's responsibility to kind of monitor this. I mean, there are always bad actors. Government's responsibility to really identify bad actors and punish bad actors.
Do you think either the Democratic Party or the Republican Party is going to step up and take on some of these issues that you care about, that you're talking about right now?
I think that to continue viable, that they're going to have to. Now, I am a Republican, and I'm going to remain a Republican. So we'll see just how many Republicans embrace this initiative.
Do you think it's libertarian ideas? Are you wanting Republicans to take on more of a libertarian stance?
Well, you know, I'm always flattered when it's described as libertarian. I saw a poll a couple of weeks ago that 60% of Americans view themselves as socially liberal and fiscally conservative. Personally, that's my view of myself. I think that that's an accurate description of 60% of America. If that's the case, again, back to these issues that I'm raising, I think, again, this is what I'm finding.
Now, do you think you've been a supporter of legalizing some drugs like marijuana? Do you think that hurts you when you're talking to other Republican leaders?
Oh, no, you know what? I didn't find it to be an issue divided along party lines. Just as many Democrats disagreed with it as Republicans as supported as Republicans. I didn't find it to be a party issue. I advocate the legalization of marijuana. And of course, when I say legalization of marijuana, never gonna be legal to smoke pot and do harm to others. Never gonna be legal to smoke pot, become impaired, get behind the wheel of a car. But I don't know why we can't make that same correlation when it came to the prohibition of alcohol. Look, people People drank, and when they prohibited the use of alcohol, people continued to drink, and now they were lawbreakers rather than individuals that drank for whatever reason. I think that regardless of the penalties with marijuana, people are going to continue to smoke marijuana for the same reasons that they drink. I haven't had a drink in 22 years. Best decision I ever made. Would the planet be better off if nobody drank? Yes. But I'm not going to begrudge anybody their right to be able to get schnockered every single night of the week as long as they don't get behind the wheel of a car, as long as they don't do harm to others. So we're arresting 1.8 million people a year in this country on drug-related crime. Half of those arrests are for marijuana. I would suggest that we need to legalize marijuana, control it, regulate it, tax it. I'm really just another tax and spend guy here because of the marijuana position. And then harm reduction strategies on all the other drugs, reducing death, disease, crime, corruption, things that we really care about. So looking at all the other drugs first from a health issue, not a criminal justice issue. Half of what we spend in the courts, half of what we spend in the prisons, half of what we spend in law enforcement is drug-related, and to what end? We have made criminals, we have 30 million convicted felons in this country today because of drug crime that otherwise would be tax-paying, law-abiding citizens. Let's stop.
So do you think that would save the state money
It would save all states money. It would be a redirection of resources when it came to law enforcement. If you or I got our identification stolen this afternoon and we went to the police station, I know you caught yourself right there. Well, we wouldn't really even go to the police station because we know we wouldn't get any results. They just don't have the resources to address, petty property crime against you or I. Well, actually, that's real crime and it should be addressed. And if we do away with the fact that half of what law enforcement does is really out to catch individuals selling small amounts of drugs, and by the way, they're very effective at that, and possession, if we did away with that, that would be a lot more resource freed up to address real crime. It would make a difference. This country would be a lot better place to live tomorrow if marijuana were legalized. We might not recognize immediately why that was the case, but that would be the case because, again, we'd be looking at real crime rather than crime, again, bad choices. We're arresting people for bad choices.
Do you think that lawmakers are listening to the people who you're speaking to when you're going out and meeting with people around the country about
this issue? No, clearly they're not. Maybe Scott Brown's election in Massachusetts is a wake-up call. It's clearly a wake-up call. And it's not about people turning to Republicans. Republicans share just as much, they deserve just as much credit for where we're at as the current administration. But the current administration is taking spending to new heights. And again, I was embarrassed with my own party having control of Congress and the White House and the fact that my own party didn't address long-term issues facing this country. And those would be entitlement issues that are not being addressed. $55 trillion in unfunded liabilities, mandated entitlements. Yikes. Yikes. What's the result of that to you and me? Well, short-term, maybe a question mark. Long-term, runaway inflation, for starters, which is the worst tax of all, that the money you make on a Monday is worth less on the Friday that you actually receive your money.
I have one final question. I know you're involved with a nonprofit, so you can't talk about particularly candidates, but do you see change on the horizon for the elections later this year?
I do. And based on just vote them out. Anybody that's involved in this, anybody running for office or holding office that has responsibility for where we're at, get them out. I mean, I think that's the sentiment right now. There is a frustration that I've never seen in my lifetime before right now. And maybe it's an opportunity to actually right the ship, if you will.